Act. Decide on the next steps. A complete assessment of the child will give you enough information to decide if the child's signs and symptoms indicate a mild, moderate, or severe illness. You can then decide what to do next. Let me show you what this looks like in practice. Remember Nelly and her 5-month-old daughter Tabisa? I found out that Tabisa had the danger sign of chest indrawing, so I needed to refer her urgently to a health facility. Take a look at what happened. So, based on what you have told me and what I have seen, Tabisa is showing signs and symptoms of a severe illness. It is important to explain the seriousness of the child's condition. Tell the family why the child needs to go to a health facility and what could happen if the child does not go as soon as possible. This means that Tabisa is very sick. She has a cough and a fever. Her body is working very hard to get enough oxygen into her lungs. You can see the muscles pulling in here below her ribs when she breathes in. This is a danger sign called chest indrawing, which means that she needs to go to a health facility urgently to get the medical care and treatment that she needs.
Oh no, I have no transport to go to the health facility. It is very far away, and I cannot walk far as my knees hurt.
Help the family solve any delays or difficulties they may have in taking their child to a health facility so that the child can get the help they need as soon as possible. Your knowledge of the patient and the community can help in solving these challenges. Let's talk about how we can get Tabisa the medical help she needs right now. Does your sister, Maria, still live with you? Perhaps she can help.
Thank you.
Once the arrangements are done, prepare the child and family for the referral. If you can, consider giving the child the first dose of the treatment, called pre-referral treatment, before they leave for the health facility. Also, write a referral note to prevent delays at the health facility. Let me give Tabisa the first dose of a medicine that will help her if she has an infection so that it can start working while we get her to the health facility. Keep giving Tabisa breast milk as often as possible to make sure she gets enough liquids. If she gets too hot because of her fever, take off any extra clothing. You can also try to cool her down with cold washcloths. Here is a referral note that you must give to the health worker at the health facility. This will tell them what I have found and will prevent any delays in getting Tabisa the urgent care that she needs.
Thank you so much for helping Tabisa, Sarah. I did not know that she was so sick and needed to go to the health facility.
It's my pleasure, Nelly. Remember that I would like to see Tabisa when she returns from the health facility, even if she is feeling better. Tabisa had a danger sign, and so I referred her immediately to a health facility. Did you notice what I did to get Tabisa and Nelly ready for the referral? To refresh your memory, have a look at the job aid. Let's go back to this situation and see what would have happened if Tabisa showed signs and symptoms of a mild illness. So, based on what you have told me and what I have seen, Tabisa is showing signs and symptoms of a mild illness. If a child has mild signs and symptoms, you can support the family by advising them on how best to care for the child at home. You will show the family how to care for the child and follow up with them until the child is well. Start by explaining your assessment of the child's illness. This may include why you feel the symptoms are mild and what the family needs to do to care for the child. Tabisa has a runny nose and red throat with her cough. The moisture from the nose drips down the back of the throat, irritating the throat and going into the lungs to cause a cough. She has no danger signs, so it is likely that Tabisa has a common cold and you can care for her at home.
Do I need to give her medicine? I cannot buy medicines as they are too expensive.
No, there is no need to buy cough medicines as they are not for young children. If the child needs any medicine or treatment, follow your standard process of giving medication and advising the family. Then, share general home care tips. You're doing a great job of giving Tabisa breast milk only. Continue to make sure she drinks more often so that she gets enough liquids. Try to continue comforting her as she doesn't feel well. Remember that a child's illness can change very quickly, so educate the caregiver on the signs, symptoms, and especially danger signs to look for. Make sure they know to take the child to a health facility if they see a danger sign. Remember, if Tabisa does not improve, or her cough gets worse, or she develops a danger sign, take her to a health facility urgently. Let me remind you what the danger signs look like again. It is very important.
Thank you so much.
Before we end, I just want to make sure that Tabisa's immunizations, vitamin A, and deworming are all up to date. We are also in a malaria area, so remember that the whole family should always sleep under bed nets. I would like to see Tabisa again in 3 days to check how she is doing. Did you take note of how I advised Nelly to care for Tabisa at home? To refresh your memory, have a look at the job aid. In summary, for signs and symptoms that indicate a mild illness, you can help advise the caregiver and family on how to best care for their child at home and what danger signs to look out for. For a child who shows signs of severe illness or a danger sign, you will need to refer them urgently to a health facility for care and support. For signs and symptoms that indicate a moderate illness, you will decide on the most appropriate next steps based on your assessment. Remember to follow up with a child whether they have been referred or are being cared for at home.